Hello, I'm Mike, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to vibe code an AI agent that lives on your iPhone and can do pretty much anything for you. And you can see here, it's preparing first of all to create a draft. And look at that, it's insane, it's done it. It's also just added my success task here to my Google Calendar. Watch down here in my mission control. And look, it's just appeared. Buy milk is now added to my Notion board. To do this, we'll use Zapier, the most connected AI orchestration platform with over 8,000 integrations and a natural language English prompt. Let me speak it now to my AI agent. You are a world-class personal assistant. When you receive a prompt, you must carefully analyze it and perform all requested tasks using only the tools you have access to. You can handle multiple tasks in a single prompt. For example, if I say email my wife about dinner and add buy milk to my Notion list, you must perform both actions. When you're finished, confirm all the tasks you have successfully completed. And there we go. I'm prompting my AI agent in natural language, vibe coding it. Let's click create agent. There we go. Look at that. That was pretty simple. Now I have a simple agent and I'm going to rename this agent, call it Butler, like so. And there we go. I've got my AI agent that can pretty much do anything for me. Now, before I go ahead and use it, I need to connect the tools, and that's super simple. Okay, now it's time to tool up my agent. I'll hit enter for a new line, and I'm going to click this insert tools button here. This is where I can pick from the thousands of apps available, like Gmail. Let's create a draft. Let's insert another tool up here, and maybe we'll search for my calendar. Yes, Google Calendar, and we'll scroll down, maybe create a detailed event would be a good one. And finally, we'll search through for another app, and we could search for maybe Notion. Yes, I'll grab Notion, and what should we do here? Let's search for page here, and oh, we can create a page. That would be a great extra tool. So you'll see there, I've added three tools. I could go nuts and add hundreds of tools if I want. The possibilities really are limitless here. Now, if you're using Zapier and Zapier agents for the first time, you will need to connect to your tools, and you just click in the cog for any tool here. It'll pop up a big field and you'll see you can connect an account. Now, I've already got an account connected, but if you haven't, you just click connect new account for any tool and it'll take you through the process to get connected to Zapier. It's literally just a few clicks and you're connected. And you'll see here that there are so many fields like which calendar to choose from, what should the summary be, what should the description be. And you'll notice that I've left all these fields as let your agent generate a value for this field. Yes, that's right. As we're creating an AI agent that can be called at any time from our iPhone, we want to give it as much autonomy as possible to do all those difficult tasks for us. So we'll look at Gmail and you'll see it's much the same. Everything is decided by my AI agent, and creating a Notion page. Yep, apart from being connected to my account, everything decided by my agent. You can see the common thread here. Now we'll set up the part on the iPhone, but there's one more thing we need to do with our Zapier agent to make sure it works. I've connected three tools, but this could be 3,000 tools if you like. We're going to need to add a trigger. So how do we trigger this from our iPhone? So I'll click the add trigger button up here, and then it asks you, how do you want to trigger? And I'm going to type in webhook, and you'll see here webhooks by Zapier. When I click it, now I have the possibility to catch a raw hook. Now, if you're worried this is getting a bit technical, don't worry. Anyone can do this. If you can point and click and copy a URL, you can set this up yourself. So I'll click this catch raw hook, and all it's going to do is give us a URL here to copy. So let's copy that URL now, and we'll be using this in a moment when we set up our AI agent on the iPhone. And here I've cracked open a screen share of my iPhone where I can go into the shortcuts app, and I'm going to click the plus in the top right to add a new shortcut. So let's do that, and we'll give it a name. So I'm going to drop down this top menu, rename, and we'll rename it to Butler, like so. Okay, this is really easy now. Of course, we can go in and we can choose an icon for this. So it might be nice to have, like, I don't know, a person. Let's just choose that person there. That'll do nicely for the moment. But for now, all we need to do is add the actions to make our Butler work, and there are just three of them. Follow along with me and get this done yourself. First, we'll go to Controls, and we'll scroll to the bottom and select Record Audio. You can also search for it by name. Next up, we're going to go into Search Actions. We can either type or go into Scripting and scroll all the way down until we find Transcribe Audio. And then for this, we need to go in and click on the Audio File section here and select Recorded Audio. So you'll see here in our Apple shortcut, so far we're getting it to record audio of what we say and then transcribe it on device. The next step is to send it to our Zapier agent. And so the third and final action, we can either search for or we can scroll across at the top for web. scroll down until we find Get Contents of URL, click that. Now, you'll see I can pop this open with the arrow here, and I'll change the method from get to post, because we're posting this to our Zapier agent. And then up here, you'll see it says Get Contents of Transcribe Audio. Well, we select Transcribe Audio, and we clear that variable, and instead, in this place, we simply paste in the URL from our Zapier agent, like so. That's the URL we copied earlier when we went into the settings over here and got that URL. So I've used my magic Apple copying to copy that URL and then go over here to my iPhone and paste that URL in the third action. Now, we're nearly done with setting up our iPhone shortcut to communicate with our Zapier agent. Just one more thing to do. So now we can click Done with this, and you'll see at the very bottom there is the possibility to add new field. Click that, and we're going to select Text, and then we need to give a key and text. Now, it's not scary. For key, you can type anything here, but a common thing when sending information across the internet is to type Q. So that was easy. And then for text, we're going to select Transcribe Audio. Click Done, and there we go. You've done it. You've set up your Butler on your iPhone, and now we're going to activate it over in Zapier Agents and try it for the first time. Okay, let's give this a test. First, I'll click the three dots on my Butler, drop down the top menu here, and then I'll add it to my home screen. If you like what you see, throw a like, subscribe. I do videos like this weekly. Okay, you'll see I've got Butler here on my iPhone's home screen. I've also got my AI agent inside Zapier with three different tools, and those three tools are loaded up down here below so we can see them getting activated in real time. This is so exciting. Let's give my Butler a go. Okay, I would like you to create a draft email talking about dinner plans for tomorrow night. I'm thinking sushi in central London with my wonderful wife, so we could make it really nice and beautiful. I'm going to send it to her. Also add an event to my calendar tomorrow at 3 p.m. called Success Making an AI Agent. And then I'd also like you to remind me to buy milk by adding it to the mission control of my Notion board, please. Okay, that's all I need to say. Now we'll go over here. Before it gets triggered for the first time, you'll get this prompt and you just click Always Allow to it. It will send off to my Zapier agent, which you can see has just swung into action here, and we can watch it work in real time now, catching that hook. And indeed, look at that. It's captured all of my text here and it's now processing this query and working with the tools to update all of my different tools down here. Now you can even see here it's intelligent enough to say I've received your request and identified three tasks. And you can see here it's preparing first of all to create a draft in my email inbox. And look at that, it's insane, it's done it. It's also just added my success task here to my Google Calendar, success making an AI agent for tomorrow, that's amazing. And now it's working on the Notion page up here. Let's watch down here in my mission control. And look, it's just appeared. Buy milk is now added to my Notion board. Three actions, one AI agent, all from a shortcut on my iPhone. This is definitely the future of working with AI agents, and Zapier Agents makes it possible. Let's just inspect the work by making Gmail bigger and opening this up. And look at this. Hi, love. I was thinking it would be wonderful for us to have dinner tomorrow night. Next up, we'll enlarge calendar and have a look. Yes, indeed, it popped in this very simple event here for 3 p.m. success making an AI agent. That's perfect. And I love the fact that in my mission control here, not only has it added buy milk, but it's also added this wonderful shopping cart icon to signify exactly what I'm supposed to be doing. We will see all along the way it identified exactly what it needed to do. I have received your request and identified three tasks. So straight from the start, it knew that. And then it started to create a Gmail draft. And here's everything that it did, which we can see is absolutely perfect. And the final output is contained there with all of the code details should we need to inspect further. The draft has been created. Now I'll make that calendar event and we look at this. And here is that calendar event all getting inserted. And again, the code that's received back that we don't need to worry about. And finally, the Notion page by Milk. It even chose that icon. This is what I love about giving agents autonomy, is they decide what they're supposed to do. And then it wraps up by saying a draft email has been created. A calendar event has been created. And also a reminder to buy milk has been added to your Notion mission control board. Let me know if you need anything else. So there you go. It was as easy as that to vibe code an AI agent using the awesome Zapier Agents interface and my iPhone here with Butler on the front here. So all I need to do is click that button to trigger Butler, or I can use Siri as well and I can say, Butler, And immediately my butler starts listening and I can order exactly what I want it to do. So there you go. It's as easy as that to vibe code an AI agent using Zapier agents and shortcuts on your iPhone. And now you've got access to thousands of tools with one natural language prompt to your iPhone. Really cool stuff, right? Comment down below and let me know how you'll be using it. Go and check out my community where I've uploaded all the blueprints, prompts, and shortcut template for you to copy and paste and try out for yourself. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen right now. You should watch next. Thanks.